My name's Matt, welcome back to the shop. And we were talking, or someone was talking, it's a weird way to start a video. Someone was talking about, or there was a question asked and then other people jumped in on the comments, that's it, let's get it right, on YouTube, in the comments, they were talking about which side your chain goes on. Someone asked the question is, why do bikes have chains on the left-hand side? Is there a real reason for it or whatever? Some guy said it was something to do with, loads of things. Loads of people have different answers for that. The fact of the matter is I've got an excellent example. I was out the other day riding around and I stopped off at a cafe place with a couple of mates and I saw a riding school, or should I say, there was an instructor and two lads who were doing their, I think they were doing the practice for the Mod 2 and stuff like that. And the instructor had a BMW, god horrible bike, it's a parallel twin. It's a F750 GS, and then the young lads who were riding, because there were two young lads, they were riding the F700 GS. Now, I had to write this down, that's it. So the 700, this has its chain on the, let me get this right, right-hand side. And this one has it on the left-hand side. And if you look at the two engines, I'll show you some pictures, they are two completely different bikes. The 700 had a water pump arrangement up at the top, basically driven off the cam, basically so you can have water pump, because that's in the head, water pump and radiator. It's quite a nice little tiny package up towards the top, where the 750 was, it's a totally different engine, literally a totally different engine, which is crazy to say that these have the registrations 750 and 700. That's quite mad, and they are two completely different engines. Why do they choose the left hand side or the right hand side? It's all about packaging, basically. It just depends how they do it. The 700 actually has the clutch on the other side, just stuff like that. You know, you can, it's all about packaging concerns. Maybe there's something that you want to do, like you want to give the bike a certain height, which means that you lose space in other regions, or maybe it's the shock, the rear shock or something like that, and you move things around accordingly, and then they come to a problem going, oh, we're far too fucking busy on this side and there's not enough room, there's loads of room on this side, not that side, and then an easy way to sort that is just to switch everything over or something like that. I can't give you the exact reasons why these are different. Both parallel twins. I don't know much about these engines, like I say, BMW, yeah, not really that interested. I'm sure they're nice bikes, and if you've got one, calm your tits down. But that is two bikes that are very similar in size with two completely different engines. I am sure that the reason is because one of these engines is fitted to this series of bikes, and this engine has come from this other family, or this is all a brand new design and they just decided to switch it. But that is the same manufacturer, same kind of bike, even the same registration, the same series of engines, series of bikes, and they have completely switcherooed everything and it's all gone everywhere. Why? Like I say, generally it's because when you design something you go, oh, do you know what, this would be so much easier if that chain and sprocket was on this side. Because it's not really the chain and sprocket so much, it's all the gubbins that go in it. So you select a drum, where your clutch is, where you've got room. Engine architecture, and you can just shift things around. Whoa. It doesn't really matter to a degree. We'll talk about mechanical precession in another video, which is about people switching their axles the other way around, and sometimes you've got to be very careful when you do that, but we'll go into that in a separate video. Hope that makes sense. There's not really much there to make sense. It was just a point that I wanted to make, that these two engines and these two bikes released at the same time, slightly different, and everything architecture wise is completely different. Hope that makes sense, and I'll see you in a bit.